just really spin this, and it makes, it spiralizes. Not now, but let's pretend. Hi, welcome back to our whole series on how to get picky eaters to eat. In today's episode, I want to cover the spiralizer. It's a super cool little tool, and it's a really unique way to get kids to eat. So you just really put any kind of vegetable. I have eggplant here. Yeah, Nora. I have eggplant, I have summer squash, I have zucchinis. It's great with zucchini noodles. So I've already started spiralizing some zucchini noodles. And as you can see, my son's eating. You want to try that? You ready? And it's just as easy as spinning this. There's a couple different shapes, and you can use it with everything. So I have cucumber right here, zucchini, you have eggplant, anything and everything you can think of. You can go ahead and spiralize, and we even have cookbooks that we've included in the description of the video and a link where you can buy the spiralizer right off Amazon. Okay, they're gonna do it. Hold on, it's a little sharp, so let me do it. What happened? So one of the ways, if you think about picky eating, is, you know, the more fun that you can make food, the more likely kids are to try the food and eat the food. Is it heavy? Yeah, is it heavy? So let me see if I can do this the other way. Oh, okay. Well, I guess we won't be eating that one.
More.
Welcome back to our series on picky eating and how to get kids excited about vegetables. And today I wanted to talk about the spiralizer. And to help, my kids are going to be here. They really love, you know, these are zucchini noodles. It makes it fun. They can eat them raw. I love to actually put them in tomato sauce and make them instead of pasta noodles. And all you have to do is just really spin this, and it makes, it spiralizes. Not now, but let's pretend. So, you know, if you think about it, like the spiralizer, you can do all kinds of foods, and it really makes it fun for kids to help prepare it. They can just kind of munch on the food as you're working through it, and you don't realize that when you, you know, offer new kinds of foods, like fruits and veggies, and you do it while you're prepping the food, it takes the pressure of having to eat it. It makes it a little bit more interactive and fun, and kids are a lot more willing to try new foods. Guys, it turns them into these wiggly worms, into all kinds of different shapes. It gives you different ones to cut with. I'll even show you off an eggplant, which is like really fun, because how often do your kids eat eggplant? Because it has such a... Ready? Let's see the eggplant. Oh, wow, these are gonna be super cool. All right, so we're just gonna work on an eggplant right now. And think about how often your kids will just eat an eggplant. And it makes these really cool little cute shapes that your kids are just gonna throw on the floor. There we go, and I'll show you on this side how easy it is to cut up an eggplant. Fabulous. Well, it's not that easy because nothing seems to be going well for my presentation. I'm gonna go back to the zucchini. All right, so look how easy this is. Is it easy? Is anything coming out?
Yeah.
All right, so it's really just as easy as that, and you can go ahead and make this in any kind of meal, any kind of pasta dish, just replace it with noodles. Exciting and fun for kids, and they're that much more willing to try new foods, and it just keeps it fun and you know, working with toddlers, never that easy. Make dinner time fun and, you know, really kind of get them involved. As messy as it is, as you can tell, it's very messy with us. It's just better for them to foster that love. Okay, we're getting really messy here. But it's better to foster that time where they get excited to be in the kitchen. I'm gonna go back to working with kids and dogs. It's just a no-no. All right, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook and Twitter, and you know, get out there and try new foods.